You may ask if the ancient Rishi had realized, relished, and shared with us the knowledge of the process of creation in the form of the concept of divinities in the Veda, the Purana, in the scriptures and sculptures, then where is the need to do further scientific research and conduct expensive experiments to unravel the mysteries of the universe?
The answer to this question lies in the Ishavasi Upanishad, one of the primary, equally ancient, explanatory texts of the Veda. The Ishavasi Upanishad had obviously thought of this question and had preemptively answered it many thousand years ago itself.
अन्धन्तमः प्रविशन्ति ये विद्यामुपासते ततो भोजीवते तमो यवो विद्याया अग्रताः विद्याञ्च विद्याञ्च यस्तद्वेदो भजग्ने सः अविद्यया मृत्युन्ते त्वा विद्यया मृतमश्नुते अन्धन्तमः प्रविशन्ति ये सम्भूतिमुपासते ततो भोज जीवते तमो जपु सम्भूत्याग्रताः सम्भूतिं च विनाशं च यस्तद्वेदो भजज्ञे सः विनाशेन मृत्युन्ते त्वा सम्भूत्यामृतमश्नुते.
We are advised by the text that the pursuit of the unmanifested reality, the spiritual sciences alone, or the pursuit of the manifested or the material sciences alone will lead us to further darkness and misunderstanding. This universe and the creation is a mix of both the manifested and the unmanifested, and a healthy mix of understanding of both will give rise to a simple answer that Dr. Penrose is looking for.
We had a path-breaking moment in science with Einstein's revelation of the relation between mass and energy. How mass and energy are interconvertible, and how the total mass and energy in the universe is a constant. With a combined understanding of creation from the material sciences perspective and the ancient spiritual expression of science, we can perhaps hope to reach the next path-breaking moment in mankind's pursuit of science, namely the unraveling of the relation between the manifested and the unmanifested, the relation between matter and consciousness, how the total of all matter and consciousness leads to the all-pervading prakriti or nature, the scientific divinity.